Hey guys, welcome back to the Hybrid Athlete channel. And here we are. We are now on Friday, the something of March. My brain's absolutely mush today. 11th, it's the 11th of March today. So tomorrow is race day. So today, this is going to be a short and sweet little vlog. It's just to talk about the last couple of days, where I'm at, what I've been doing nutritionally, and what I've got with me for the big day. So got back into Chester yesterday. I've got all my kit laid out on a table just behind me here. Whoop. Everything nice and laid out, all my nutrition and stuff there. In terms of nutrition for the big day, all I'm taking with me is because there's lots of well-stocked aid stations. I know what foods are there, the foods that work with me quite well. So most of what I'm taking with me is I've got four fluid bladders in my running rucksack. My little Solomon running rucksack served me well. So I've just got four of these, so I've got two in here, and then two packed in the top with the rest of my gear, waterproof, so on and so forth, maps, all the essential safety gear, with around about 50, 60 grams of carbs in those. So that's going to last me the first 4 hours or so of the race. Around about 44 kilometre mark, I have a pit crew to meet me to restock those. So I've got all the Tupperware in my drop bag laid out with all the powders and stuff in it. Throw those in. I'm also carrying with me for my race day nutrition, just to keep on top of like water stops. Even if I'm not filling my bladder, I've got a little kind of reusable cup that just folds up and literally fits into the back of my little pouch on my shorts. And I've also just got some salt stick salt shoes as well, just in case they're like emergency electrolyte source if I start to cramp and things. I tend to keep my nutrition, that is my emergency nutrition and things that obviously quicker access at the top of the bag. So to be honest, come race day, I don't think I'm going to need to be getting too much stuff out my bag unless I need waterproofs and things like that out of there. Typically, even if it rains, I don't think the weather forecast is particularly horrendous tomorrow. But even if it rains, to be honest, I generate quite a lot of heat, so I dry quite quickly. So the one thing, a bit of in terms of equipment or clothing for warmth tomorrow, will just be a decent pair of gloves. So I've just got some North Face gloves, which keeps my hand warm. Rest of the time, I'll probably start the race in a t-shirt and a light, I think I've got a nice light Solomon, kind of like running long-sleeved base layer type thing to slide over the top if I get a little chilly. So yeah, prep's all done now. Got my drop bag sorted, so in my drop bag, because this course is muddy, so much mud. I've got a spare pair of trail shoes. I'm running my Gore-Tex ones to start with. Hopefully that'll keep the mud out, but obviously it depends on the depth of the mud. I was thinking about wearing gaiters or getting gaiters, but I'm not sure. I'm still undecided on that. Maybe discretion is the better of valor, and I'll take those with me. But in my drop bag, I've just got my carbohydrate powders to refuel those. I've got some little snacks, change of t-shirts, a couple of warmer hats and a couple of warmer layers, just in case if the race does get slow at that point, there's going to be periods of walking where maybe it's just more beneficial to be dressed more like a walker and a hiker than it is like a runner. So I've got all that just in case. Nutrition this week's been okay. It was a bit bizarre coming off the back of the powerlifting competition last weekend. I think I touched upon this on Wednesday's video. My nutrition went back fairly to normal. Didn't really feel like I needed to overeat, even though I was trying to get my weight down quite aggressively for the last few days. So I kind of made the decision, like I was saying in the last video, to fuel up quite a lot on Wednesday, Thursday. To be honest, would it be normally what I'd fuel up on? No, but I've really felt, I don't know if it's because I eat quite a low fat diet normally, and I'd obviously dropped quite a lot of weight quite quickly. I really felt that my body just needed energy rather than carbs. Let me explain, just overall calorie density. So I've been really craving a lot of kind of fattier foods, salty, fattier foods, which is usually indicative of me, of previous experiences of maybe, you know, I was dieting down to get ready for the powerlifting competition. Those energy deficits are starting to catch up on those drivers to eat. So yeah, definitely been gravitating more towards kind of burgers, pizzas, things like that. But I'm just mindful I also need to put the carbs in there as well. So Wednesday night, I just really wanted something that I fancied. Like I've been really good with my nutrition. Disciplined, not good. I've been disciplined with my nutrition to get my weight down. And I really just fancied something that I fancied. So I got KFC on Wednesday night, which was wreaked a little bit of havoc on my digestive system because it doesn't tend to cope too well with too many fats and spices, and I had loads of hot wings. I know they're not super spicy, but you know, I don't handle spicy foods the best. So yeah, that kind of wreaked a little bit of havoc with my digestive system, so that wasn't ideal, but it wasn't bad. And then yesterday was when I did most of my loading up, to be honest. So through most of the day, it was just very kind of bread, soups, fruits, little bits of snack treats in there, a little bit of chocolate, some sweets, odd little cookie and things like that as well. Typically what I try and do is get around between 10 and 15 grams of carbs per kilogram of body weight, but split over 2 days. Just being a bigger person, that amount of food volume, I don't really like feeling heavy in my digestive system. And then last night, which is a bit of a pre-race ritual now for me, not that I didn't want it, I did want it because I ate it, but a bit of a pre-race ritual is a couple of nights before, I got myself a pizza, some wedges and stuff as well. So yeah, that was all my fueling done yesterday. I only got myself like a small pizza and like small portion of wedges and stuff. Yeah, probably didn't need that much fat in my diet after the day before, but it's a little pre-race ritual. It sent me to bed with a full stomach and sent me to bed happy. And as much as I'm not a, superstitious person, you know, whenever I've had good runs and things have gone well, that's what I've tended to do, is carb and a bit of fat load a couple of days before. Obviously, you can get away with having a bit more fat in your diet whilst eating carbohydrates if you've got more time. If you're fueling up the day before, you really want to avoid too much fat. It slows digestive system, slows digestion, and particularly if you're not used to a lot of fat in your diet, then it can wreak a little bit of havoc on your digestive system as well. Though obviously, if you're an athlete that runs, like, is more fat adapted, prefers a higher fat approach, again, not necessarily a fan of that, but I'm not going to get into that here. But if people are more fat adapted, they consume more fats in the diet, then obviously it's not such an issue. Conversely though, if you are an athlete that has a lot of fat in the diet and then all of a sudden you decide to carb load, just be aware to do it gradually over a few days, because again, our digestive systems are adaptable. You know, the enzymes that break down carbohydrates and things will reduce if we have a lower carb diet. So if you've had a restricted carbohydrate diet and then we try and carb load, again, can cause some digestive system upset, likely to end up, you know, getting things like osmotic diarrhea, which is basically undigested carbohydrates, sugars, starches make the way into our gut, pulls in water, and then we end up with a bit of a tricky bowel situation, shall we say. That's also really common with taking on too many carbs, and particularly, you know, too much glucose or too many sweets without enough water, or just too much that we can absorb per hour. So I know I can take on board 50 to 60 grams of multiple transportable carbohydrates. By that, what I mean is a combination of things that are things that are glucose or broken down into glucose, and fructose as well, which is fruit sugar. So I'm using, and again, not sponsored by, I'm using High Five. I tend to get on with this really well. It's a multiple transportable carbohydrate, so it's a mixture of fructose and glucose in the form of maltodextrin. Yeah, so it's 2-to-1 glucose, well, maltodextrin to fructose. And the reason that we can get a bit more carbs in there with less discomfort is because you have two types of carbohydrate transporter. Fructose goes through one, straight to the liver, typically speaking. Maltodextrin / glucose and those derivatives go in another. You've usually got about twice as many of the glucose transporters as you do fructose, hence why there's that 2-to-1 ratio in there. You can push that up to 90 grams. I've seen people have up to 120 grams of carbs per hour. I just think with the intensities at which I'm going, 50 to 60 grams, 240, 250 calories, as well as a bit of solid food each hour from the aid stations, should be good. I'm mixing those. Typically speaking, you don't really want to get more than a 10% solution, so 10 grams per 100 mils of water. Most of your Lucozades and things like that are about 6-7. That's fairly safe, 6-7%. I can push it a little bit higher. My body tends to tolerate it a little bit easier. But, so I've got about a 10% solution, so 60 grams and 600 mil, give or take. But I will also be using, that's one of the reasons why I'm using the my foldable cup, is to keep sipping on that as well, just so I'm getting a little bit of extra water in there. I also know that my body can take on board about 800 mils of water per hour before I start to go overboard and then needing to pee all the time. So that's a nice little blend for me. It's just obviously watching what's going on with the digestive system. And, you know, in the words of Robbie Burns, the best laid plans of mice and men, Afghan Aglaé, so I'm playing everything a little bit safe. And if I need to slow down and eat or take on food and fluids, then I can do that. So yeah, my eating the last couple of days, it's not been ideal. If I'm being honest, I would have liked to have reduced, had a little bit lower fat and a lot more carbohydrate. Not that I've had lower carbs, but I've just, yeah, probably had a little bit more fat than I would have liked. But I've, like I said, I just felt like my body's needed it, probably off the back of the approach that I'd had to get my weight down for the powerlifting competition. My weight's all back up to normal now. Urine colour's back up to normal, adequately hydrated. So that's another thing I'm trying to keep on top on today, is getting my water intake, fluid intake back up. So a combination of squash, and I'll also sip on like Lucozade and things as well. Just a little bit easier to get in. And then today, so foods for today and tomorrow morning, I'll work in reverse order. Breakfast before I go, I don't really like to eat too much. Most of my fueling's done. You're not going to be depleting glycogen overnight tonight. I like to just have something which is easy to digest, full of protein, and then maybe a little bit of carbohydrate. So I might have a muffin, a bagel, some toast, something like that, just one or two pieces. And with breakfast, I will have, I've got these from Marks & Spencer's just because it's quick and easy, just a couple of low-fat Greek yogurts, a little bit of protein in there, things like 10, 15 grams of protein. So there's about 9 grams of protein in each one, so 20 grams of protein. Again, amino acids will help prevent that muscle breakdown, but amino acids are also important for our brains detect amino acid levels, and that can be elicit feelings of fatigue and stuff as well. So typically speaking, on these longer runs, I'll always try and have at least one good protein meal with me as well. So obviously in my drop bag, I'm going to have some protein snacks in there. One thing to watch out for if you're having things like protein shakes is my digestive system is incredibly sensitive to artificial sweeteners, particularly for whatever reason it is in protein shakes, ready to drink protein shakes, when I'm doing like longer runs and stuff. So I will tend to, if I'm gonna have, well, protein snacks is in there, it's gonna be something that's like whole food for me, find it much easier. So like a little packet of chicken, I've got some biltong and stuff like that, just so that I can get in that 3 to 4 hour mark, get a little bit of protein in there as well. Just, I find that helps. And obviously, you know, I'm going to be out running for 8, 9, 10, possibly 11 hours, depending on the conditions. You know, you need to get some protein in there. It's going to, every little is going to help in terms of cognitive benefits, potentially fatigue reducing benefits, and also preventing that muscle breakdown, which is then going to also, elicit a response, which also is a regulator of fatigue centrally. You know, our body detects circulating amino acid levels and things like that, and those, the tissues being broken down, so can increase perceptions of fatigue. So that's breakfast tomorrow. Today, again, to get that protein in nice and light on the stomach. Just realised I've just spilt something on my top. Oh, lovely stain there. Couple of protein yogurts. I've got some pretzel thin salted ones. So again, just getting my sodium levels up, so I'm nice and hydrated tomorrow. Easy to snack on. I've got some fruit gums. Again, I'll probably just chow on them this evening. Nice and easy to digest with lots of fluid. And then my last real meal today, which I'll probably have about 5, 6 o'clock, which will be what you would call like starch heavy, will be, I've just got some pasta. I'm not going to eat all of that, with just some like bolognese sauce. Again, I won't have a lot of that, just to give it some flavor. And then if I feel like it, I'm not necessarily going to have this, probably just a few bits of garlic bread. I'm going to try and get that last big meal in by about 6 o'clock this evening. Again, just because I don't want to wake up in the morning feeling heavy. If you'll notice that's quite low fiber, there's a reason for that. It's white pasta, white bread. You know, I'm not going to use I'm not using anything too fibrous today, just because again, it sits in your stomach and is likely to wreak a little bit of havoc with the digestive system. And then the only other thing I'll have today, and again, I probably won't eat all of the fruit gums. I'll just take some of those and maybe snack on them in the morning just before the start line, just to get that blood glucose levels up. And those I might just throw in my bag and in my drop bag as well. So I'll only have a few of those tonight. One thing I will have is a little bit of a treat. Nice little chill to the end of the day. Again, quite lowish in fat relatively. Nice bit of protein in it. And nice bit of sugar, carbohydrates as well. Is again, just some Greek style frozen yogurt. Just something nice, relaxing, you know, enjoyable, that kind of cognitive benefit of just enjoying food. And yeah, before a race is massively important. I think people can massively undervalue the benefit of kind of comfort foods in a race situation, you know, to give us that sort of psychological boost, you know, that like we can enjoy our foods as well. You know, the last thing you need the day before a race is, you know, miserably chowing down dry pasta and this, that, and the other. And, you know, we're already putting enough stress and pressure on ourselves to go through, you know, regardless of what race distance. But, you know, especially doing up marathons and ultra marathons where you know the terrain's going to be horrific. I want something that I'm going to enjoy tonight, like the process of training and dieting and everything else and trying to balance all my strength work has been a struggle enough without, you know, not having foods that I enjoy and that are comforting. Now, I know from a weight management perspective, comfort foods can be a big issue for a lot of people. But in this situation, I find that this last day in particular, not putting too much pressure on myself to be like super restrictive, just really helps me psychologically. And because of that, it reduces my stress levels, which then helps me sleep better. My sleep this week, just before I bail, I keep saying these videos are going to be quick and they never are. My sleep this week has been horrific. I couldn't have imagined a worse week's sleep. Partly my own fault, partly circumstance. Partly the fact that, if I'm being honest, this week, and this is what I'm trying to remind myself, and maybe I'm lying to myself a little bit here, this week is just a test week for what's going on in a couple of months' time, which is the 100 miler. So the way I figured it was, if I was doing 100 miler, there's no way I'd done a powerlifting competition the week before. There's just no chance. No chance whatsoever. But because this is 50 miler, I'm on a very strict time budget. I need to be off the course by about 4 p.m. So I'm not making excuses now. I will run until 4 p.m. Luckily, the way the course loops is it's not far from home, so I can get home. I've got to be off the course by 4 p.m. I've got to go somewhere tomorrow evening. That is unfortunately, that is time restricted because I need to catch a train. So whatever's done is done. I'm hoping the race will be done. My predicted race time is about 9 hours to 9 hours 20. But again, a lot of that will depend on conditions, which would get me done about between 3 and 3.30. Yeah, which isn't exactly ideal, but I can push on the course till 4.30-ish. I can get off, get home, get showered, get to the train. It's basically the plan. So I'm trying to not get into that mindset of, like tomorrow is, it's not a race tomorrow. Tomorrow is a training run that I'm going to push myself and work on strategy, because a lot of this course is going to be on the 100 miler that I'm running at the end of May. This will also determine today, and I'll update this on Monday, whether I choose to do the British Championships 100% for powerlifting, because that's 2 weeks before the 100 miler. Now, one thing I will say today, the day before the 50, is that last week, because I hadn't really pushed up the weights that I wanted to, I've just got a few little kind of like strains and niggles and things from last week. They're not going to stop me running. I don't think they're going to have any terminal effects on my ability to complete the 50 miler, but it's just not psychologically where I want to be, particularly having missed my last training runs. Well, had to cut my last training run a bit short because of the storms that we had here, and I was out on the course at the time. So this sounds like I'm making excuses now. It's not. I'm going to work hard for about 10 hours. Where I'm at 10 hours, if I'm at 44 miles and I have to come off the course at 44 miles, that's fine. I don't mind. It's all miles in the bank, and that's where I'm at. Ideally, I know they've adjusted the course slightly because there's been some issues with cows, so who knows what it's going to run. Again, tomorrow, and I'll post pictures, and I'll try and get some footage when I'm out and about. Like, you'll see some of the terrain that is just mud, and I mean mud. So again, depending on how accessible it is in terms of accessibility to run, that's not the right term, how easy it is to run, or if it's runnable, or how navigable that mud is and how much it slows me down is the great unknown with trail running. So I've decided now in advance to take that pressure off myself. But like I said, I'm in a fortunate position where, because the course loops, and at that point I will be no more than 10 or 15 minutes away from home, I know that if I need to get off the course, as long as I'm home for about 4:45, I can make my train, because my train is from 20 minutes away at just before 6 o'clock. So I need to be back here so I can get in a shower, get together, get refueled and gone. This is ridiculous. Something I shouldn't have done in terms of in hindsight. But unfortunately, I think part of what makes my journey relatable, or I hope makes it relatable, is the fact that, like, look, I am a busy person. I have other commitments. I try and balance my training with business and and life. You know, I do make sacrifices, and I'm fortunate enough to be in a position where, you know, I have my own clinic and I don't have certain lifestyle constraints. Like, I don't have kids and I don't have, you know, those kind of commitments, which eats into my training like many other people do. But I also am very aware that this idea of being the hybrid athlete, it's not just hybrid in terms of strength and endurance, it's hybrid in terms of living as much of a normal life as I can, sacrificing in the areas that I need to, but not sacrificing everything, because I'm not a professional athlete. I do this because I love it, and I do this because for me it's an experiment in where, what I can, how I can push myself within the constraints of my life. And I think that helps me with clients, because most of the people I work with, even the professional athletes or good level amateur athletes, most of them, they have a family, they have a career, they have a job. This is my version of understanding that. And sometimes we have to understand that discretion is the better of valor. So that's the approach I'm taking tomorrow. Because if I do push too hard and I do miss this, it's going to affect my personal life. It's going to affect my business life of stuff I've got to do, because I need to be somewhere tomorrow evening. So that's my excuses laid out on the table now. But like I said, I'm hoping to get round and be done by 3:30, 4 o'clock at the latest. But I need to be off the course by 4:30. So we'll see what happens. It's just a training run. I just need to remind myself of that so I don't hurt myself, particularly off the back of last week. The goal is still 100 mile at the end of May. This will be a good indicator of that. But regardless of what happens, I'm just going to enjoy the experience. Like I said, sleep and nutrition could have been a little bit better this week, but sometimes we have to just play the hand we're dealt, and that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to enjoy it. I'm going to do my best work today in terms of refueling, try and get an early night tonight, and then we'll see what happens tomorrow. Might do a little update on the morning on my socials and stuff, but yeah, I'll do a video log. I'll do updates on socials, but I'll probably do a video log back on Monday morning talking about how it went generally. But race updates and links and things I will post on my social media channel. So if you follow me on those, great. Keep an eye out and you can follow me live and see how far I get in my cutoff time. Right, see you later, guys. Have a good rest of your Friday. Have a good weekend. And I'll speak to you all on Monday, hopefully with 50 miles in my legs and still in one piece. Peace.